get stunned and silenced often. This was one time where I was just left flabbergasted. Taxing units of government, which includes the city, the county, the CTA or RTA, which funds CTA Pace Metro, the Chicago Public Schools, the Water Reclamation District, Chicago Park District, Chicago Library District, are all running huge deficits. And now the state of Illinois is talking about raising liquor taxes again, cigarette taxes again. Raising the income tax by 50%. I mean, we are taxing our way out of existence, and by all indications are not willing to learn any lessons. But when you look at the collective burden of all taxes, federal, state, sales taxes, excise, home rule taxes, gasoline taxes, various fees that are charged, Cook County, Illinois, we pay over 50% of our gross wages in taxes. That includes real estate taxes, income taxes, home rule and excise taxes. So it's a huge bite. One half of all the money that you make gross goes for paying taxes.
And of course, you know, you get somebody like Todd Stroger saying, well, we can't lower the taxes. They have to be higher, and maybe we have to raise them again in a year because we need the revenue. But they don't seem to understand that in raising the taxes in an effort to increase their revenue, doing so almost always, in the long run at least, reduces the gross because people are going to go outside of this county and pay a lower tax in the next county or across the state line if it's convenient. And so they end up so often with a net loss. Do they not talk about this in the halls of Cook County government?
No, they don't. Because that view of tax, borrow, and spend was best encapsulated by my fellow commissioner, Deborah Sims, who represents the Southland area of Cook County. When she said during a finance committee debate to me once, Tony, don't you know this country was built on taxes? And my reaction was just stunned silence. I don't get stunned and silenced often. This was one time where I was just left flabbergasted, and after about 15, 20 seconds, I came to and I said, Commissioner Sims, with all due respect, this country was not built on taxes. It was built on the backs of entrepreneurs who formed businesses and provided jobs and employment for people who paid taxes so that you can get your paycheck. Because she has never worked in a private sector in her entire life. Her money gets deposited electronically into her checking account, and you know she expects it to be there every 2 weeks. I work here with 10 employees in this law office who, you know, every 2 weeks expect to be paid, and I have to go out there and earn that money. And it gives you a whole different perspective on life.